Fala do aqui. You get your tuba half hour ago. You are over Doshi. What are you going to do, eh?
Man, I only want the pain to stop.
Well, the Panadol ain't helping. Everything for you is Panadol. Your teeth hot is Panadol. Your stump, your toe is Panadol. Your constipated is Panadol. Your ass scratch is Panadol.
Man, shut up, man, Sarwa. You give me share and cut up your belly or tissue.
So now you got an excuse to get you more Panadol, right? Go ahead.
Man, shut your mouth, man. It's 4 o'clock in the morning. You're trying to wake up all the neighbors.
Everybody in the house don't wake up. Just now, Falka can open his big mouth and holler, and nobody can tell you anything.
Well, shush, man. I don't understand why she's getting these pains like this. Last month was the same thing.
And it's the same thing what I told you last month. I'm going to repeat at 4 o'clock this morning. It's not really girl got, and ain't got time when it's coming.
You think I don't know that? But I was hoping, well, that the hot tea and the dip.
And the Panadols?
Yes. And that the Panadols would help.
So get some more hot tea then.
That's really bad of you, Shifaro.
Is your worry taking all these years, Kunti? Look, I know you don't want to wake up Narma, but she's the only person who could night drink a Narma.
Man, I know that, man. No, but I can't go over there so early. Today is Saturday, there's no forward to sleeping in late.
Look how long we live here together. You think Narma will get vexed forever time you catch her for her drink a Narma? She's like a mother to she.
I know. But I just feel bad having to go and ask her every time this happens. And then she's gonna come to me rescue. Man, look, come drink some more hot tea.
But you know it's a cold, it must turn iced tea. Look, go wake up, Norma.
Man, you go, man. I just feel bad having to go all the time.
Me? Oh, then no. This is the time proper boy, no from staying out late all night. With crap outside.
Daddy!
All right, I'm going. It's only because my doctor belly.
What?
Well, blue belly already hot, if you know what I mean. You know what? If we shout more, they might wake up, and I got to go outside and disturb crap on your family.
Sarwa!
All right, I'm going. This is a tell Crapo good morning.
You mean you got to use that just to go next door?
Even if it's in the bedroom, Crapo, me don't go to the same party.
Sarwa, your daughter belly hurting.
If you belly hot and well, it would have been a different story.
Not an earthquake, no, no. Flood couldn't wait.
What do you mean, my dog? I thought we was neighbor.
Ah, so what? Don't worry with you. I going over.
You got a good chance of all the money bumping your gums.
Thanks, Miss Norma. That's what I'm trying to do. But all the cold but wake up is like he's still sleeping.
I am not getting into your story. And don't Miss Norma me. Not because today's the Freitas' birthday, y'all gonna have a good start of. You know what?
Today?
Yes, today. Some good friends of the two of you.
I'm glad you're home, and I'm sorry I had to wake you up.
Look, you see, if you won't be sent, I can just go back home, you know. Because if something is affecting somebody over here, it means that it's affecting somebody over by me too. Right? Good.
You eat last night, Rebecca?
Not much, Auntie Norma.
You have to eat, young lady. Come. Lie down here. Let me see. Come, tell me. Bring some soap. Come, let me soap. Thank you. You hold shake. I'm going to push up this chair. Yes. Yes. Nara, yes. You young people are only with your heads sticking your iPads and your cell phones and not finding time to eat.
Aye. Let me see.
Mm-hmm. Winner, yes.
All right. I know it hurts you.
You're going to feel better just now, right?
All right.
Make a little hot tea for she for me.
Well, look at the cold, Matt. We forget we good friend the Freitas born it today. Thank God for Narmo.
And he don't forget we own. No, I got to get you a gift, but things are tight right now.
Don't worry about him, man. He don't need no gift. All the Portuguese people rich.
Man. You know, yeah, I like to categorize people because of how they look.
All right, ma, who y'all you talking about? It's me you talking.
You know what I mean. Not because this Portuguese means he rich. They got poor Portuguese people too.
Well, he got for me the exception then, or if this we want me for believe.
Man, so we get the kind of thinking out of your head.
What thinking?
You're categorizing people because of how they look.
All right. You so scratchy when you wake up, man. Like you sleep on sting in that lower. Huh? So what are we gonna give you?
We?
I thought I should say we. Because we having this conversation. Plus, things will bad with you too. What man wake up?
Hey, you should have seen a look for your face, Spike. Well, you know. He don't really expect nothing from me, you know.
Because he rich, right?
No! Man, he don't expect anything from we or anybody given this hard times.
You know what? I think I'll give he a full bottle of rum.
So that you could have access to drinking it, right?
What do you mean? It's the thought that comes. And if the thought comes with a good and a smooth aftertaste, that's even better.
So what you doing, change, eh? Look, by the time the sun raises head, I can decide what we get, why you get it.
Watch. Just make it more easy. Give you another bottle of rum.
So that it could also be available for you, right?
No, man, look, today's Saturday. Let me tell you, come over. Conti and Arma could knock up some food, you know, not nothing too fancy. At least they can eat some stress while we celebrate the birthday. Plus, it never killed me for kill one of them yard for the occasion.
All right. Okay, guess. Not bad. You know, sir, what you're really thinking?
No shucks. Kunti, everything all right in there?
Yes, it was narrow.
You see, you must listen to your husband.
And husbands must listen to.
Well, but you must listen to your wife.
And you too. Yes. And always remember to eat on time. Because when pain is no easy pain,
touch your head for it. Look, come drink some of this hot tea.
You know when you're married and you're gone your way and you get narrow, I wonder if you can still call me. Only then it would be a different kind of narrow.
Miss Norma, I am not getting married for just now. And even if I do and I get narrow, you have to call mommy number two.
Well, listen to your mommy number two and eat. You know, I got the same problem with Kevin. I don't know, like, eating is a big problem for these young people nowadays. Because they are too busy doing I don't know what with technology as the excuse.
Rika, when you finish, I want you to go get some rest. You know what's going to be happening here later, knowing that today's up in the freezer's birthday.
It is?
Yes. You know, you're just like them two outside. Look, I go in, girls. Call me if anything, eh? So, where you going with that tea?
It's for the two of them outside.
But they ain't got no narrow.
But I got a lot of hot air coming out of the mouth, though.
So, they ain't gonna bring out more? You sure you won't give it to them?
Well, that can't be cured by rubbing their bellies.
All right. See you, Rex.
Here, boys. Have some early wort.
Tea?
The least you could say is thanks. Look, it's too early for the other things.
Aunt Kunti, it's never too early for some roti.
Don't worry. I'm gonna make some just.
Good. I can't wait.
Look, don't worry with no roti now, cold pot. It looked like we got to start light while we're still in the dark of the day. Cheers with this tea in anticipation of the morning celebrations.
Man, look, so well, drink the damn tea, eh? You haven't seen anybody cheers with tea.
Continue, you know what it means, right? They already decided and planned for us.
Mm-hmm. It looks like we're going to be having a long, hard, tiring, but I'm sure fun day.
You're telling me?
Oh, here we are, ladies, going to do. Norma, I want you to make the pepper pot.
All right.
Kunti, make sure you make some roti, make some curry, you got to make kalori, my channel, everything.
I'm glad that you're feeling better.
Mom told me what happened this morning.
It's fine. My own care has no seconds. At least Miss Norma's always there to rescue.
She knows all about those things. Nara, I'm here. Bad eye, you name it, she could fix it. That said, that is how we met her.
We had her.
Oh, I think we had her here. She didn't believe in those things, especially since he claimed of not being around things.
Sounds kind of crazy. Her here?
He had her here every week after that.
Can that happen?
Mom said it was just an excuse to meet her. Until one day, our father checked his eyes, and he realized it was really going on.
Really? What happened?
He got married not too long after.
Grandfather didn't want anyone fooling around with his daughter, especially with half years and excuse.
Oh, how romantic.
I know. Look. I'm worried that you're getting these narrows, but it appears to be getting worse every time.
Don't worry, I just need to eat on time.
I wouldn't want anything to happen to you.
Nothing would, okay? Just bad eating habits.
I have said this before. You need to take care of yourself.
do mean a lot to me.
Say it again.
What?
What you just said.
What? That you mean a lot to me?
That was a question.
Do mean a lot to me.
That wasn't hard, right? You do mean a lot to me too. Look, I promise I'll be more careful in the future, okay?
I hope so. Well, that's having your tummy rub is a way of keeping it flat without exercising.
You're joking, exercising.
Cheap. I know this might not be the right time, but are we going to, you know, do that thing?
What? Oh, that! Well, my tummy just I wouldn't want to overly harass myself over the next few days. Next week, I guess?
Okay, no rush. I just can't wait to do that with you.
Same here, I want to do it only because it's you.
I feel special and can't wait for that thrilling moment.
I guess you have no choice.
Yeah. Finish your assignment?
Not fully. Maybe later tonight. Don't know when this part will finish.
You know how it is when they all meet up. Not even children can compete.
Hey, little lady, little man. Y'all kids all right?
Yeah.
Something wrong?
Why you ask?
I'm supposed to come here to a party by the casino, where? Am I in the right place? Some black one from South Lady. Hey, Copper! So, what kind of warehouse party are that here, man? Look how quick they're gonna run up, watch.
Hey, what nice you're making cassava bread. And that's all the manners you got? Making, recognize for a change of people's plans?
Look who talking about manners. Look. Proper manners would dictate that you would invite me inside to eat. And don't forget, you invited me here to a party, so you should have been here to receive me.
Ah, why you don't shut your trap? Eh? You just like how to create nice pollution. Plus, you don't need no invitation. See, now just settle. What happened?
What do you mean, what happened? I come here for a party, but like I see the way. Oh, Uncle Pat, don't worry about eating out all the roti like your mommy, do you know?
Don't worry, sis.
You're scandalous with your big mouth, boy.
My picker, don't worry. You got plenty.
Happy birthday, Porgy. May you live until you die. I hope you witch catch me, boy.
Hey, but you know, y'all are some good friends. How you want to know about this party today? If I didn't call now, I'm going to ask you for cooking pepper pot.
Oh, I see. So you mean to tell me that you forget my birthday too? I understand these two need memory care to remember things. But you two? It's only the women that remember my birthday.
And it was the same thing last year and the year before. Anyway, man, forget about that. The main thing is that everybody here.
Yeah. No, Rekha, you and Kevin come and help me bring all the food stuff.
Good. Well, I go over and bring the pickle. And Fikau, I hope you got appetite, because Mr. Sorowa, he didn't make joking eating.
Well, I got appetite wherever you got to give me now.
Hey, let us stay just on the pepper pot, right?
Pepper pot whales. Like you forget the days before you get married. I used to come to Nama for follow up with hard hair.
Hey, Kopat is a lucky man. Very few men got a woman that could pull up on here. Norma is a godsend to you.
It's sad that Kunti can't say the same about you. She is the godsend. You're more like a hug and not the hair.
She is.
Yeah, have fun, man. It's you, boy.
Hey, but y'all is some good fellas, I tell you. Why y'all is always treat me like this? I'm always the last to know about anything the two of you plan.
The problem is, you got all the syndrome. You just always call me before we could call you. Right, Corpo?
Yes.
We would have called you at the right time. Why you think we can do all this and don't call you?
Yeah, right. Why? Is it because you assume that people who look like me does only live in the bush? So the messages take long for reach, or we don't get cell phone signal.
Man, that's yourself, man. Calm yourself down, buddy. How much times we got to go through this, eh? We forget.
Oh, we. Speak for yourself, Corpa.
Hey, you forget to.
As usual.
All right, you don't got to shout. The good thing is that this forgetfulness happens every year. So you know where you're lying.
But wait, man. I got to say this. The way the two units operate, this make me want to believe that because black man and coolie man outnumber us, you have deliberately make us the last to know about anything the two of you plan. It seems like three small numbers just get lost in y'all larger ones. It's both us and the body that's been forgotten.
And you, sir, friends?
Defrate us. I know you eat. So I can't say that this hunger make you talk and stupid. At least the silver bread got an excuse.
No. I only hungry for pepper pot. Hey, by the way, I just stopped my phone and asked if you didn't come in.
Oh, shucks! Corpat, you forget song too?
Me? It's not me, Gordy. Don't blame me.
Garbage. This is the point I'm making. It seems like because we number small, we important. But I guess it's only your friends that's doing it, right?
Hey, some friends though. Corpat, so what? You get half again?
I didn't know we'd have a trial. You know what? Y'all wasting time that could be best spent boozing and throwing tantrums.
I second that.
Let me bless this body with a drink.
Hey, Nalo, bless me with some of your pepper pot, y'all.
Curry.
Oh, goody. You know I can't live here without eating you roti and curry. But let me give you the pepper pot first. I hope it's just the pepper pot you're talking about.
Actually, oh, goody. You know he's a pepper pot man.
Cheers. Let us be the first of many to follow. The drinks of me, right? Happy birthday again, Potos.
Happy birthday, Cabbage.
Come, Norma. And my love, don't let yourself go.
Just one drink you take, and you're calling me a love already.
Oh, man, just take it when you get it.
It's only when you drink I deserve these nice words.
Take it when you get it, because sometimes I don't even hear it at all.
But there's a woman in the big mouth to talk about other things, right?
Well, you know something. They don't like to talk about it. Certain things. Jesus could come and go back, and they still won't want to talk about certain things.
Well, I know that Cole Pot is not the type of man to talk about certain things. But he got other ways of showing it. You see, my Cole Pot, I'm defending you.
Hey, who are you, Sora?
Hey, don't drag me in your story. And you know what? I think this part is steel. It needs some music. Reka, put on something there for daddy.
Trust you for changing topic.
Inspector Ayase, you know y'all can't do without each other.
You mean y'all?
You know, right? Because when can't come between the four of them.
Hey, Fred, what happened to Fong?
Well, Fong said plenty of food sellers. He can't leave the restaurant.
Hey, he's a smart one.
And you won't come screaming, hollering about how you insignificant because your number's small? Just imagine the confusion to be in this country if Fong and the other Chinese friends are supposed to close up the restaurant for 2 days. Then you must see how powerful smart number is.
Look, don't go wishing them thing on us. Y'all got wives, we don't.
Good. So don't come tell them nonsense about how insignificant you are because your number's small.
But that's how we made to feel. When you are too kind of engage each other, you always forget about others. Well, cassava bread, don't do that. You are too forgetful.
just like how Reiko forget about the music. What happened, girl?
I had to clean the CD, it wasn't reading.
That's because they didn't went to school. It's not one CD I got, you know.
I know what you want to get, but it's like.
I hear what you said.
I know I wanted to play the one that you like.
Oh, all right. Come on, drink up, please, not little boys, eh?
But all right, whenever anybody gets hungry, we have lots of
food. Music, girl!
Yes, I can get it.
Hey, man. But so what? you got any hammer in your music.
It's not you, Barton. And even if it was you, Barton, it would have been different. Oh. We would have been playing and dancing it for her.
Thanks. Hey, now we talking. Hey, I'm going to try some of this roti and curry.
You're sure you want to try some of the curry with some cassava bread?
Hey, your meal is only cassava bread and meringue, is it?
So where else you are, is it?
It's good for you. Since this morning, I'm trying to talk to you about a generalization. It's not just cassava bread, is it?
It's not about generalizing. It's about making you feel at home.
Hey, good excuse. Look, I deserve to feel at home when I go at Naban Kunti. And it ain't anything to do with cassava bread. The problem is that the two you have is here.
Well, Narva, let me go inside and finish this little drink we start.
Yes, girl. Let's go and leave these evil men on the road.
Wait. Just like that?
We might just say you have a holiday on the
day. It's all right. I know it's hard to prepare all of this. And them two able-bodied men can do nothing but pass orders.
Hey! Use your mouth to eat cabbage.
Hey, you know something? Y'all got some good wives, you know? Y'all so happy with y'all family, man. It's always encouragement to have one of them.
Dog yard, whoever she be, God bless she. You have my deepest sympathy.
Look what I'm saying, my ass! Stupid dry humor. Mama, you know it has always been strange with every week. I've got a family, I've do.
You mean half important and the other half insignificant.
You might be right. Why not? Here is where family is.
I drink into that. So, is fun coming?
Is fun coming? You don't know Fung by now. When Fung restaurant closed, it's still open.
Hear what he is doing. He's closed the door and say, I told you when you're great.
Hey, this is how you must make money and buy the bandits.
Hey, you don't got to convince Fung about making money, you know. This is all he and his kind are about.
Ma, you just like so, woman.
What do you mean?
This is how you see our Chinese people. They're not all Chinese about the same. None of them is about making money.
All right, why you tell me this? You ever see a Chinese beggar?
Not really.
You ever see the Chinese here fighting each other? The way you and Sora kind of always bickering among yourselves?
Mm-hmm.
You ever see the Chinese here fighting about politics and who was voted for who and who getting contracts? And who getting marginalized, and who against parking meters and
all that? Right.
So what's your point?
You don't get it?
No.
When the two you kinds fighting, they're progressing. You know, I never see a Chinese minibus driver, a Chinese carpenter. In fact, I never see a Chinese media. And you know, I never see much as public servants either.
Ah,
but we had one as president though. Don't forget. The first president,
though? Yeah. I know. But you don't see Chinese people here doing certain things, you know?
Man, there must be an exception, so we're not all of them into business.
Well, if they got any exceptions, they're exceptionally invisible. Dog is like Fung not visible here.
All right, so Fung not coming. There's one person less for share this expensive rum.
You mean share my birthday gift?
Hey, it's about sharing. Look, I share it.
Oh, you know something? When you think about it, right? You know me, I really pass them Chinese people.
What make you say so now?
When you go into a Chinese restaurant, right? We the show, hey, Chinese, have veggie fried rice with it. But you would never go into a coolie man or black man shop and show, hey, coolie man. 2 pint rice and a half pint tie. Hey, black man! Half cook up with fried fish.
Never.
So what's the
issue.
I know, but pulling man and black man does make it an issue though, right?
That is because we're too sophisticated with the language.
You mean you have frankly to call each other that in public?
Paper. You know, long ago, it was never issue with black man or Cody man. Mm-hmm. Tell me, you remember this?
Oh no.
Cody waterized. Yeah. Black man sala, pong sala. Hey, that used to be fun back then, boy. But now when you say it, they say you're disrespectful.
But we don't see the Chinese people in the way though.
Petko, I like how you're talking about Chinese people and other people. Why are you talking about you people?
You know what I mean?
Well, things have changed for you and your kind. Look how you're dressing fancy now.
Hold on. Why we must stay the same way? Why we mustn't dress fancy?
I ain't never said that. But yeah, I get noticeable makeover. In fact, it's no longer Amerindians, it's indigenous people.
That is a big fancy word. If you talk, I want to know how much of you people know what a word means and if they could spell it.
Wait. So what do you think we want to know? We ain't backwards, you know? It's things like that that's going to stick when I pass.
I ain't saying, dog. But think about it. First was Buck. And they used to consider that disrespectful. Then Amerindian. Then forest people. Now it's indigenous. Which next, banners? It looked like Naga more rights more than anybody else with so much a description.
So what's wrong with that? We are Amerindians who are the forest people, making us indigenous to this country.
So what? You're sure you understand that? Duh, it's fancy language.
How you mean if I understand though? I didn't go to school in August.
Well, just like how you know, don't assume my people don't. Not because we come from the bush means we chop head.
It's good for you. You like to generalize about people too much. I drink into that.
You know something? Yeah, two kinds feel you are more smarter and knowledgeable more than anybody else. But all y'all doing is fighting each other and forget how it affecting others. It's not the two y'all alone is living, you know?
But me say nothing, bro, like that. All the same here, you're on the same side.
You don't have to say anything. The whole country knows. But nobody wanna talk about it.
Talking about what?
You know. And it's only when we drinking rum. Talk about it.
Rum does bring out certain things that them liars and them wives can't.
That's why if you can't lie, you shouldn't drink rum.
But this conversation was not only happen when we drinking rum.
So how you expect to have a conversation without rum?
So we can't drink otherwise?
Look, cabbage is right. For too long we don't want to talk about certain things. For example, they got a racial divide, whether we like it or not. We sense it, some even experience it. Yet we don't want to talk about it. Look, call a spade! Skirting around it is hypocritical and it won't help. This thing exists. How big it is? Well, there's another issue.
I agree, but not in all places. The issue is, we don't come out and tell each other how we truly feel. You think Kulima will stand up and tell a black man how we truly feel, or look, vice versa?
Look, this is not about black man and Kulima. This is about all of us. What affects one, gonna affect all.
So how you think we feel, buddy?
Come on. You know, let's be honest. Some Indian people have this stereotype how black man is bully, he involved in crime, or don't like what? You may not want to say it, so I say it for you. Tell me if I lie. And as I said, be honest.
What nonsense you're asking me? You know they got some Indian people fit some of them saying things you just described? For years, me and Cole Patty's neighbors, and we never had a problem. And that is being honest.
There's plenty like you and him living in harmony.
The issue is certain sentiments run deep among the group. Sentiments that cause certain suspicion and mistrust. That is what we must talk about.
Mistrust? Mistrust is the bitch.
So what do you think? I can't tell a black man how I feel about him?
I never said you can't. But would you?
Why should I? We ain't got no problem with them.
That's taking the easy way out. This country have a lot of hypocrites. Who put on a smile in front and resentment behind it?
Hey! I ain't no hypocrite! I don't see Colpatt and his family different from me.
I agree with Cabbage. There's still generally a deep sense of mistrust among the two groups. That's the reality, whether we like it or not. Not for everybody, but don't tell me it don't exist.
Well, I don't see Colpatt or Narmer as bullies nor fakes. They just work hard and they never try to take advantage of me or me family or anybody for the matter of me.
The two of you are like little drops in the ocean. Give them out to Africans and Indians in this country. And the problem is the mindset that comes from generation to generation. That mindset has to change.
Yeah. So, you see how Kuliman see black man, right? How you think black man does see Kuliman?
Man, black man, Kuliman must speak for themselves. Where's your brother?
What do you mean what I say? We ain't got a problem with Sorwa, your family, or anybody else, so don't ask me nonsense.
That don't mean black man don't have resentment for Kuliman.
No, it's there, and it is there on both sides. But they're afraid to talk about it, to get the weight off, and move on.
Well, here, me ain't got no weight to get off. You see how we fit?
You could joke how much you want, Sorwa, but you know exactly what weight I'm talking about.
Hey, man, look. We here to celebrate you, Gordy. This is not the time to talk about things like that.
So when is the time to talk about it?
Oh, the two of you are so aggressive, eh? Is it food causing though? Because if it's not, at least I didn't cook it, you know?
I know you didn't cook it. But, as we were saying before, how black man feel about Kuliman?
But tell me something, it's only two of you must talk about it and not us.
Oh, you end up in a conclusion, man. You know, you just like the media. I didn't say a dog. All I was saying is that this conversation is taken away from the celebrations. This wrong didn't come for staying the battle. It need help to come out.
Just like how this conversation need help. We mustn't keep putting it off, Sora. We must talk about it. We can help.
We? That's not for me or you to talk about. That's for them politicians.
That's why it can never be talked about. We must talk and force them politicians to act.
Why? It's not like they just listen anyway. And besides, this is not America.
Man, look, forget America. Here, one party just gets support from your people, and the other from his people. Yet none of them would never say publicly that they're either an Indian party or an African party. While they both benefit, they're afraid to say it.
But this is not a country of one kind of people, so you can't say that they're supported by one or the other. Mm-hmm. It got to be national.
Look, nationalism must not be hypocritical. Look, I don't see anything wrong with that accepting that you're representing one of the major ethnic groups or the other. They're not saying it. But when they get into power, it shows up. Then you get tons of complaints about victimization and discrimination of a group or the other, depending which party is in government.
By accepting they represent a genuine concern of a particular group, they won't be seen as racist.
When the PPP represents an Indian concern, they are called racist. When the PNC represents an African concern, they are called racist. So, who must represent these people? That's my point.
You know the two y'all are too bright for yourself? Yeah. And who representing you and you people fit now?
That's a scary question. Representation must come how we look. One must be represented by all.
Look, this country, This country is divided whether we like it or not. Look, you just name one village, and you're going to know which party most of the people in there support. The way things are, it benefits the politicians, so no need for them to fix it.
You know, it's a good thing you don't got a wife. Because if I was your wife, and you wake up the way how you saw me now, I would hide all them cassava bread.
And you know, if you was a woman, I don't think any man would want you. And if anyone here was a woman, yeah, I'd make a cute couple.
Whatever happened to the question of black man female coolie man?
I think some black people got the stereotype that coolie man getting all the opportunities of making money. They just see them as rich, corrupt, and just trying to get richer. Being elite.
I look rich to you. You know how much blasted poor coolie people have got and who's struggling for their living? It's not all coolie people rich.
It's good for your sore wall. You're always generalizing. You see how it feels?
All right, you ain't got to shout. But how Portuguese and Bokman know how coolie man and black man feel about one another? Why black and coolie can't talk for themselves?
You hit the nail on the head. Someday, you two kite must find the courage to honestly talk to each other about your feelings and concern. Whenever that day happens, it will be a good day for the country.
I don't know who you're talking about. Me and Colpat, we always talking. And we start since 4 o'clock this morning.
You know what I'm talking about.
They got a social cohesion ministry. They could do the talking now.
Ah, so well, you know what social cohesion means?
Don't ask me though. But whatever it means, the intention sounds good.
With our good intention, we can't have cohesion if one or some people are made to feel unwanted or discriminated against after every election.
Anyway, you know I don't understand? They're spending taxpayer money for bring some people together on one hand, and on the other hand, they're spending taxpayer money for prosecute some of the same people they're trying to bring together.
Well, sir, well, the road to prosecution must be seen differently. When something is wrong, you can't turn a blind eye.
But there's like building a bridge and breaking it at the same time.
But if it is wrong, it can't be right.
Look, for cohesion to come, it must first start with the politicians, especially the government of the day, regardless of who it is. They got to show that they mean to bring the people together. They got to bend backwards and continue to extend the olive branch.
But why the government got to do that?
Because they're the ones in power. And the pressures on them to genuinely demonstrate that it's unity what they want. Look, the opposition got a responsibility, yes. But the government must lead the way. Starting the ministry is one thing. Going the next stage is far more important.
But why can't Granger and Jagger meet more often? Why they can't meet regularly and maybe have a public breakfast every fortnight or so and pay for it? Rotating venue and payments.
So what Duggan do?
Look, I am positive that the image of them together will certainly help to diffuse tensions. And by paying for it out of their own pockets, they can make them look ordinary like you and me.
That's good.
I sure people would love to see them.
That's a good idea, but there's problems with that. Don't agree on having the breakfast. When to have the breakfast? Where to have the breakfast? What to have for breakfast? If it's Bible Joker and our fufu, and who gonna pay for the first breakfast?
This probably grunts for another commission inquiry.
You gotta take a bed outside in winter for wake you up.
I don't know about you guys, But the success of the Ministry of Social Cohesion lies at the mercy of the cabinet and other politicians. What they do? They decide the path to cohesion.
Taki Mado. You Portuguese people don't mix up with nobody else but yourself. And you talking about us?
So I don't count. I am here mixing with you.
You? You's probably one of them half scholars.
Hey, but it's true, you know, out of that one or two, you really don't see Portuguese people mixing up. And you certainly don't hear them getting involved with what's going on.
That's because, like, Rupuduni, cowboy fit cow. We not into fighting, and we don't get involved.
So if we don't want to get involved, how do you expect to find a solution for everybody?
Well, when y'all two kinds stop fighting each other and start involving everybody else, then we gonna find the solution.
Oh, so you want we do all the hard work and you benefit?
What work, Copac? Call it as it is. Our voices are not heard when the two of you through y'all political parties start screaming at each other. Them decibels way too high. It must come a time that our voices must be heard.
Then you got to speak up more loudly.
Look, that's what we've been shouting for years. Nobody listening?
Y'all boys all right? You birdie boy okay?
Yes, Coons. We talking about cricket.
See, y'all need anything?
Yeah. For you, go inside.
All right. Thanks. I gone.
You see? We even afraid to say who we talking about.
Who afraid? Is that the same politics in cricket?
Look. Don't even mention the word cricket to spell my birthday.
Ah, right. But it's only because it's you, birthday.
Hey, life funny, eh? Imagine, we know the problem, but we can't find the solution.
Some people has lived their whole life without even knowing what the problems are.
And ours glaring in our faces.
But problems aside, you know, I am so happy the way we live as a diverse nation. We got to be thankful. Plenty other countries envy us.
Some got tribal wars and fighting to figure out why they're fighting. Or fighting to figure out why they shouldn't fight.
Hey, despite all the problems, we not so bad after all. Give us some credit.
Well, you did some Mr. Just now, though.
Hey, if only the politicians would listen to us.
For them to listen, you got to make noise like music in them minibus.
Ah, they got to listen. Don't forget, another election coming.
Right.
It's true. I got to get transport to vote.
Transport? To where? Portugal?
I miss all this one. I am Guyanese. I stayed right here for it.
You better, because Portugal didn't want you to eat up.
And India wants you, or Africa wants Copa, or China wants Fung.
So who wouldn't want Fit Cow?
Nowhere! It's only we who didn't come from anywhere. We belong right here, and we will not be taken for granted anymore. Indigenous!
Yeah. You know what? Y'all taking this liquor for granted. Come drink up.
Hey, I just look forward to these gatherings.
And for you, wifeless too, for eat.
It's an opportunity to eat good food.
You mean for free?
Hello, Narma and Kunti are like my sisters.
Hey.
You mean you're free cook?
Remember, those sisters have husbands.
Tell them.
They ain't deaf.
Shh. feel the silence? Nice. Let me hope it stay this way.
What do you mean?
Down the road, when election comes, you know what that has bring? Fear, uncertainty, violence, chaos.
Man, look, things like this should be happening in this modern time, man.
Election must bring fresh ideas to move us forward. It must bring hatred, mudslinging, character assassination, or division.
I hope this election brings the re-election of the government.
What? What do you mean re-electing the government?
What happened? Is the liquor making it difficult for you to hear and see?
No, hold on. I see and I hear it well. But from what I'm seeing and hearing, there is a need to change the government.
Really? I'm what grounds you saying that?
Answer what? If by what they're doing and what everybody else seeing, you can't see that there's a need to change.
So you're saying I blind then?
Well, if you're seeing what's going on, well, you're certainly blind.
I see him, and that's why I'm saying a change is not needed.
What? You never expressed support for this government? How come all of a sudden you're doing so?
You think it was sudden? Not because I wasn't saying anything means I wasn't supportive of this government.
So will you of all persons switch? I always feel comfortable knowing that me and you share the same political belief.
That was before, and I recently switched. I fought it quietly for them in the 2015 election.
So, why you didn't tell me?
I didn't know I had to tell you, or it even matter.
This is news to me. You and this government?
Look, I got a right to change my mind, and I got a right to decide on my own who should govern me.
You know, things is not as good as it used to be before, man. Don't stifle your conscience.
This is not about conscience, Corbett. You political belief in your party blind you from seeing that things getting better. I mean, it's not perfect, but who is?
But sir, what? You is the blind one, man.
You got to be the blind one not to see that this government needs to be re-elected. Not me, Ray Charles.
So, well, no, you got to be the blind one, not me.
Me? Not me. You! You ain't got cataract. You got a set of bricks blocking up your eyes.
Right?
Open your eyes and see.
Guys, take it easy.
My eyes are always open.
But they're not seeing.
Guys,
you stay out.
Yeah, but why you must stay out?
You stay out too.
Yeah, but why?
This doesn't concern you.
Wait. You serious?
Yes.
All of a sudden? What the hell went wrong?
Ask him.
This is because y'all can't agree on whether the government need changing or not.
Now you guys, he behaving like a fool.
Who you calling a fool?
Whoever asked any question.
Wait. Young man, come on, man. Y'all serious?
You see me laughing?
Just like that? After all this time, we enjoying ourselves. Know this? Corbett, just like how you feel the way you do, he has the right to a different opinion. That's democracy.
So you picking up for him now?
I'm not picking up for nobody. I stated a fact, friend.
But friends aside, I can't believe that after all this time, he now telling me that how he feels about the government, that the government should be re-elected.
And it's the same feelings for me about you.
That's his. He has the right, just like how you have the right to say it needs changing.
It looks like only certain people here got rights.
So, wait. The party finished?
I am finished. I can't believe that after all this time, he now telling me how he feels about the government.
So you mean to tell me this is what caused y'all to feel the way y'all do?
If the government changes or not, y'all still got to be neighbors and y'all still got to earn a living. You think food can just drop at y'all doorstep? That's not the point.
So what's the point?
do you think I can be comfortable knowing how he feels about the government?
So you mean to tell me you feel uncomfortable because there are political differences now showing up? We must never assume who I support politically.
I can't believe this. One mention about elections and the two of you ready to fight.
I didn't know he feel the way.
So what? You guys are friends. Don't let politics come between the two of you.
This is about trust.
What about trust? What about this Kamek you not trust him? You trusted each other all this time. Come on, man. You're a big man. Set an example.
I repeat, the government needs changes.
And I am saying the government needs to be re-elected before I felt neglected.
Before things was better off, man. Man, look, remove your blindfold.
It's because I remove it, make us say what's saying.
Now, then if we can't agree on this, then we could never agree on nothing else.
Well, we would agree that we won't agree.
So what this means now? Y'all followed now?
Well, if by us not agreeing, then things would never be the same.
But you could differ on politics and still be friends.
It would never be the same. That gonna bring suspicion. Don't fool yourself. You know it, he know it, and I know it.
And that's the suspicion we need to get rid of.
If Jack Dion Granger can lead different political parties and still talk to each other, why can't the two of you?
You think they're talking? That's just for show.
Now, how you know though? Huh? How you know though? I'm sure those two men want the best for this country and they committed to it.
After all these years, they still can't find a way forward, really?
Yes, but that takes time. And it's not just about them, it's about us too. Look, I won't really question Granger or Jack Dio's commitment. If only pride can be put aside and the country be placed first. Look, they got always got a government and they got always have an opposition, whether we like it or not. But that doesn't mean that them or us got to be enemies.
I beg to differ. I would put some of the blame on all our leaders. If they were to act a certain way, these two fools won't be acting this way.
Hey! I ain't no fool!
Go over the cabbage!
So you are followed because of this stupid disagreement?
What got to happen? Got to happen.
But it doesn't have to be. It doesn't have to be this way. Look, y'all children inside studying together and y'all wives enjoying themselves. This gonna affect them too. Look, when y'all two fight, innocent others get hurt.
Well then, maybe it's time to get home.
Don't even think about it.
You know how many people love to have the harmony that we just had here a few moments ago?
Don't destroy that.
Both of you.
Look. I say the government needs to be re-elected, whether he like it or not. Is he wife and child, and if he want to go home, then there's he right.
All right, so you're up. Look, y'all value this friendship and put this stupid political difference behind.
Come on, brothers, listen!
Listen to you for what? If I don't support this government and he don't like it, then is he problem?
Same here!
Now that's it. Norma, give in! Come! Now!
This is what I've been saying. This is what I've been saying all the time. You two guys never want to listen to. Listen, if you listen to us and others, this friendship will not be broken.
God, Pat, we're wrong.
Everything. Come, let me go home.
Why?
Come and I can tell you.
What happened?
I say the government needs to be re-elected and he doesn't.
Oh, see, I drink too much rum and now you're talking crap. Now wait, this is a
suddenly a problem?
That's how dead people are. Why force your opinion on others?
You want to force your opinion on
others? I'm not taking crap from
and
you.
I wouldn't take it from you.
Shut up.
What?
Shut up, woman.
Stop.
You shut up.
Is that what you want, Sorwa?
Yes!
Kopak?
Yes!
Well, if that's how you feel, then I should stay on.
Me too?
Yes!
Then I got to go. The two of you. You all continue to fight and destroy what you all have. Destroy this friendship, everything. So damn predictable. Look, I'm fed up with this. Time will tell what both of you have done. You think your graves in the yard will be green, yellow, or red? Huh? I hope your leaders can see what's happening on the ground and the impact it can have. I hope it can be a lesson for them too.
Wait, y'all don't have to go, guys. It doesn't have to come to this.
Would you leave them?
Why should I?
Let them go!
See, y'all happy now? Eh? I didn't want to have to say this. And I wouldn't have had this stupid quarrel not happened.
But we were hoping that this little celebration would just for a moment help you cope. Forget that you lost your job and the wheels have stayed closed down. The freighters and Fitco left money with us since last week for us to prepare. We didn't want to take it, but they insisted. We all acted as if we were surprised this morning. Same when they came. Man, they know how hard it has been for you and Norma Copan. We know. What is wrong if you're a long-time supporter of the PPP and so supports the coalition government? Man, look how happy we were just a few moments ago. That is what we wanted to ensure today. Happiness. Man, we are a family and families stick together. Why we could enjoy this, eh? But no. Y'all just had to let stupid politics divide.
Look, this is not a Brady Bunch or the Obamas. It had a good reason why the estate had to close.
How it could be a good reason and left thousands of people out of a job?
All in plenty estate, the only bleeding abortion in the country. Change is always hard and you know it.
Hey, stop it, stop. Stop.
So well, could I ask what you meant when you said just now, that is how they people are. Who they people you're talking about?
Y'all.
Really? Really, Sorwa? Now I am they people? Eh? I never see they people or your people for all the years that we live here next to each other. I never see your people when I come and rub rake a belly.
I know you want to talk about it. It had to come out one day.
It's not talking about it. I am making a point. I never know that you would see me this way as dead people.
It had to come out one day.
What had to come out?
How you people are.
Us? I thought we were family.
Well, it looked like your waist attacked.
Man, don't talk like the man, Sorwa.
My Norma, calm down.
No, how can I be calm? This is nonsense.
I don't even know how this nonsense started in the first place.
Well, it takes two to argue.
Well, when you he get into your house, y'all could argue.
Sorwa? You saying that to me?
Well, I said, I done said.
That's like the, well, same here.
Kevin, get home.
Rekha, inside.
You get inside.
Daddy?
Look, don't ask me stupidness, girl. Get in your damn room.
You girl, inside there. Norma, I never expected this from you. Yes, well, you have to always expect the unexpected. Eh? All these years we live in here, and y'all harboring feelings. Shame!
Hey, don't talk to me, wife, like that.
Hey, you don't talk to my wife.
Now, y'all stop this man. No. Let it come out. Now we're seeing the true faces. Okay. So now you want to take advantage and bully us.
Hey, you don't call me no bully, you coolie wretch.
Who you calling me wretch? Who you calling a coolie wretch, you black wretch?
Hey! Don't abuse me, wife.
Oh, you don't abuse me, wife.
Hey!
Trust me.
Have to get it somehow.
today. Today.
Everything happens at the right time.
Break up. Break up. Get your lip box down inside this house. Now! How many times I tell you I don't want to see you talking to me? Eh? How many times? Why the hell do you continue to disobey me?
Kevin! What's going on?
When you hide and talk to people like that, what do you think others will say about us, eh? It's shame you want shame me, your father.
What?
Don't butt mommy. Get your lip box right inside this house and don't let me ever see you talking to people like that again.
You've been talking to she, right? You want some good brat side of your behind. Yeah? It is hard. Stick brat in it.
What happened? Same thing again.
Yes.
Well, when I tell you for change your box side in here, you say no. This same girl gonna make her go for walk with me head down. Get in the down room.
You looking for trouble? I tell you not to talk to the girl again. Because it is possible what you didn't do, they can say you do to she. You ain't got for touch for getting into trouble, you know. You have other friends. Get inside.
Kevin, why you keep disappointing me, boy? Hmm? Me and mother ain't talk to you already about this. Me ain't got money for pay liars if them people was a pin stories on you or some other bad action, you know. Come inside, son.
Look, it look like she want mad. I go to school. But she can't want suck in and blow whistle at the same time.
School first. You got to watch it more close.
Well, then you got to put in cameras because it's only school I said.
Cameras my ass. Look, that means you ain't gonna do no work. Just keep your two eyes open.
For what?
Use that, your mother. Look, come take up my food, man. All this damn nonsense getting me more hungry.
What? Hungry? You, daughter, hiding and talking to man. And you hungry? What for God's sake?
If you listen to me and tie your blasted foot, she can carry out.
Boys got to learn to be responsible too.
So you gonna be responsible when they go like money?
But that's not the point.
Let me tell you what the point is. The point is that they don't want the child talking to black man. They quick forget black man bad name. But the rake is too hot. And you think that Kevin is a fireman to put out your flame. Only God knows what she been doing for Shabelli hot shake.
I'm a man, you can't talk like that about a child.
She's not no child. The more you live, the more you see. Eh? Look, you see how now we know how they're thinking about we? Can't believe it.
Look, now I'm hungry, I'm gonna check out my food.
The food ain't done cook.
Are you outside?
Hello!
What?
Long in, I'm coming just now.
master I. You must good I. Tum pas aaye, you muskuraye. Tumne na jaane kya sapne dikhaye. Tum pas aaye, you muskuraye. Tumne na jaane kya sapne dikhaye. Ab to mera dil jaage na sota hai. Kya karun aaye? कुछ होता है क्या करूं आए कुछ कुछ
don't like see other people happy. They're too damn envious.
Hey,
Don't make your blast rise and pass. We think we got time for waste with you.
I need a plane to set a nice loud, loud just now. Nobody could understand it. Why don't tell Snacks to play a nice loud?
You calling me music nice? You don't know damn good music when you hear it.
So you admit you're playing it loud after Snacks, you hear?
So what, So what? When you didn't play with this, you didn't play just now that nobody could understand. It was all right, right?
You're right, because you is nobody. And because you is nobody, you can't understand it. And when you can't understand, you try for Danny. Great! Y'all don't want any music playing this country.
Hey, hey, hey! He's not nobody. And this in India.
Hello, it's the same India music he danced to the other day. And by the way, this is not Africa.
Hey, so them days got long. And the dancing got long too.
And you can't even well blast the dancing.
Yeah, you watch him out.
And you watch yours.
Oh, shut up! All of you, I shall charge you all for disturbing the peace, for being a set of nuisances, and to show disrespect in the presence of an officer of the law. I could just imagine what goes on around here. You don't need music to disturb people.
What goes on around here is none of your business.
When a report is made, it becomes my business.
I'd love to know your counsel. Who made the report?
I'm warning you!
Sorry, well, shut up!
Lock you up!
Yes!
You shut up, too! That's a warning. Now, one raker complained about loud music coming from Lot 21. And one, Kevin, from Lot 22.
You're not to call names?
You call police for me? You are spasming your...
You?
Wait. It got to be the cell phone you called from. I'm going to show you to kiss my ass phone. Pass your ass inside.
I can't believe this. My own son?
Shame us. Come. Today can be the last day you will have the dog cell phone.
Officer, there is no music playing here, sir.
You don't need to play music to be a nuisance from what I am hearing.
You sure you're not a reporter about a crime that needs solving? Why you don't want to solve one?
No. I need to speak to the two persons who made the report, so that I can ascertain that this situation is under control before I leave.
Kala, you need my Quran. You shameless thing, you. You know what people will say about us now? This can be the talk of the village.
You satisfied? You satisfied? All me life a police never come knocking at me door. What has gotten into you, boy? Man, look, pass!
I must make sure to tell you the noise they're booming loud from over there, too.
Sir! I need to speak to the two people who made the report. Sir!
We coming, sir.
Further action to be taken.
No, sir.
But you know that's wasting the officer's time.
Please understand. I'm sure by you coming, they won't do it again.
I don't know. When we don't respond, it's one problem. When we respond and you don't want action taken, that's another problem.
Well, didn't think you would respond.
What?
I didn't mean to be rude, sir.
They are our parents.
I don't know. But you've got to realize the seriousness of making a report and don't want any action taken.
We do. Please fear them. And us.
Okay. We don't like doing this. But you can do this.
Yes.
What are you waiting for? Go. I don't buy it, come. Had it not been for the concerns of the two young people, you two would have been walking back to the station with me. Now, this is now an official warning. If there's another report about disturbing of the peace, be prepared to exercise your legs, okay? Do you hear me?
Yes.
Do you hear me?
Yes. Yes.
Let me hear you!
Yes!
Have a good day.
I must try changing the name, sir. Well, imagine, though. Me old Tato calls a policeman to come and warn me for playing me own music in my own blasted house. Pass your ass inside door.
I sure as them over there.
Pick up a beat. What is wrong with these young people today? Eh? I couldn't do that when I was a child. It would be a whole week of cut ass.
We're not church not yesterday, Mom. Hello. If I met you, I don't ever forget that.
I is the man in this house, and two big men can't live in the same house.
Look, pass your ass inside door.
I don't hear what you're
saying. You know what? Some people just can't mind their own blasted business, you know. Hey, you over there! I go play me music, and you know the slack officer can't stop me.
Yes, you fool. Is that we make the report?
It's your son.
You know, when you stop it, you stop it. Because you don't to call the police, too.
Hello. It takes a stupid one to know another.
I will play me music for me enjoyment because I work hard.
So, what you trying to say? That I pick up what we got? I walk me ass off it, though.
But your right foot too, for your enjoyment is not your right to disturb on ours.
It's y'all be disturbing us. My look so high, people say they can't do nothing about it.
My look, call back, you play your music, I feel like dancing.
My love is you for playing loudest.
Our music set is way bigger than the excuse you got over there for a season.
Just like your big ego.
My goodness.
It's music you want, it's music you want there.
Okay. Good. Well, if you is it, it's war. War with music, Sorwa.
Yes. You know, I ever call me Sorwa again. Sorwa is a gravy and curry. And I ain't too gravy for you nor your damn family. You address me as Mr. Raj Kumar, Harry the Ryan, more than that, Raghunandan, nothing else, brother.
Okay, good. If that's what you want, then you don't stigmatize me because I'm black and call me cold pot. Not because I'm black, I got to cook you in one or is associated with one. You address me as Mr. Rudolph Edward Theophilus Benjamin Mackenzie Sorwa.
Stop calling me now, Sorwa.
Don't call me Sorwa, Sorwa.
You stop calling me Sorwa, Sorwa.
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 Don't call me. Don't call me Sorwa, you crazy.
Yes, you're all a backward stove.
Look, stop it, yeah?
You stop it.
Look, look, look. Hey, now, me husband is not an old stove.
Well, then you need spectacles.
What?
What we saying that?
I said you need spectacles.
Huh? Nothing is wrong with my eyes, but you can't see the long one to sew a gravy with a fork. Now tell me, who does use cold butter these days? Y'all need to get where the types is, gas stove.
Oh, you forget where you come from.
Y'all need to get what you want in this life.
Hey, you stop it right there. Me husband is what blasted hard for we want. So were you really trying for say Kunti?
You know exactly,
Norma.
You're too jealous.
Jealous? Jealous? Jealous of you for what?
Of us. Everything we got or do is burn your heart.
Girl, look, my heart wouldn't even waste time to be jealous of you.
That is because you're heartless.
Yes, and you are made out of concrete.
At least I still half one.
What?
No, not enough. Let me go inside and let these fools alone, yeah?
Yeah, yeah. You better do that because I fed up seeing you ugly face out here. Your big face.
You should be the last person talking about big face. You wouldn't even be able to recognize the word big face if you see it.
Why I got to recognize the words when I see you?
Yes, you illiterate fool. Look, mama, let me go inside.
Yeah. Do that. I got for one sanitize my eyes from watching you.
Pass me,
cool.
I'm
a bit of hydro wallet, so he can't see over here, and I can't see his big face. Watch, Kunti. Want to go back in there for carry all the bad eye. And tomorrow, I got to collect some sink for. Where do y'all going, eh? Kunti ain't cooking today.
Why y'all run y'all about cussing outside? Rekha running with belly pain inside.
What?
She called me because y'all can't hear her cries inside.
She in a damn cell phone again.
You should go and check out the cell phone.
I can't believe what happened to these new families all of a sudden. Over the election. I just hope she will be all right.
Touching my daughter.
Don't be foolish.
She pain is terrible. She can't bear it.
Let me take her to the hospital.
Hello, my dad is working. He's rubbing. So she won't leave. I'll get you more happy then.
Look, I didn't want Carl now, but this is about a child.
Don't do that, Cabbage.
Stop me. She's like my daughter too.
Cabbage, don't do that.
Watch me. Namo! Namo! Namo!
What, Cabbage?
Shrek, I need your help. She's rolling with belly pain.
I'm busy.
Namo, please!
I'm sorry, I can't do that.
Namo! Do it for me! Rekha is not one to cause all this problem. Please!
Namo, go back on my garden. There's a child. Show that you have big in heart and in mind, man.
Yeah, no. I know you can hear me. Your mother, Rekha, innocent in this. Do something. Please. I know you're better than that.
Look, I know me daughter then, Ben. But don't beg anybody for shit. Your parents still alive.
This is the kind of thing that causes stubbornness in the first place. Your daughter has a stake.
Look, it's me daughter, and I can carry her to the hospital.
Please, please, somebody, please do something, please.
Mama! Mama! What? What? Maybe it's for
some good reason.
For good reason it could be for my daughter lying motionless in hospital. Eh?
There must be one. There's only he up there knows.
Don't talk nonsense. Me daughter being in hospital could never be good.
I know how you feel. Mommy feels the same way. Calm down. She won't want you to be angry.
Your hands get cold. My hands get cold. Just my heart to be touched.
Go.
Why? Why should you not eat that?
Come. Come so. Come so. She'll be lost, Austin.
I don't want my daughter to die. Please, I don't want my daughter to die, Kevin. Please. I don't want my daughter to die.
That's so mean. You got to be strong for us.
Obsessed with fighting each other. Then, just then maybe,
My mom could have come over that night and helped. Who knows what difference it could have made? Can you honestly live knowing that if we were to lose her? If you... It doesn't have to be like this, Uncle. If you only know Reka, she's passionate about life. She loves life and knows that there is much more to it than what her daily routine is. She never thought about the present alone, for she's always forward-thinking. She's ambitious and wants to make her parents proud. She knows how hard her dad works to give her education and promise to make him and Auntie Kunti happy. She said she would build a big house and have maids so that her mom wouldn't have to lift the straw. And her dad, he could play his music without having any coupon in his hands. She believes that to be her duty and has a plan for her life and the things that she wants. She is exemplary among her peers. How sad that her dreams and aspirations may never be realized, all because of your darn stupid fighting.
Different parties and still be the family we were. Why? Only you can do that. Only you can be wise and understand that politics does not have to divide blacks, Indians, Amerindians, Portuguese, Chinese, whites. We all look different. We can't change that. But we can change the way we think. We can change how we interact with each other. We can change how we see each other. We must force our politicians to change the way they think. We must force them to face the reality that politics must not be used as a tool to divide us. We must force ourselves to face the reality that politics must not bring out the worst in us, but must bring out compassion, respect, and tolerance of who we are, why we are here, and what we can do together to make things better. Look how beautiful we lived until fighting unnecessarily over an election. Election must become like another event. Who is hurting now? Not the politicians. When you are divided, you want us, the children, to also be divided. It does not have to be like that. That is what Reka wants to change. We are children of all of you. We are you. She is you. I am you. I am us. She is us. Can we really afford to be divided? Tell me, can we? Mom? Dad? No! We can't! Despite our differences, we can't! For the stakes are too high. Too high! Instead of quarreling with each other, why not tell your politicians, for them and their followers, to break down the barriers that divide us?
Tell them to genuinely work to smash the fences of racial and political hatred. Tell them to do genuinely all they can do to ensure that no one feels inferior to the other. Tell them to do genuinely all they can do to remove the fear that if a government were to change, one group seemingly becomes superior to the other. Tell them to do genuinely all they can do to remove the fear that if a government is to change, that one section of society would feel alienated. Tell them that our governments must be for all the people. Only then can we begin to forge unity. If not, we are fooling ourselves. Tell them to set an example of togetherness among themselves first. Tell them to start in the parliament. What if we were to follow how they behave in the parliament? Why would they want to drown out and belittle each other when speaking in the parliament? We want to hear them speak. We as children don't behave this way, and if we were to, we would be punished. The government and the opposition need to work together and set the example. They must rise above political narrow-mindedness and put our country first. Our harmony must come first. What would we have without harmony? It's scary to think. That is what you should fight for. You should fight for them to lead by example. Cohesion starts there. Unity starts there. Let us not shower praise on each other only after death. Let us learn to appreciate each other while we are alive. Let us demonstrate how much we value each other by looking into each other's faces and saying it. Let us not be hypocrites.
Each other. Mom, Dad, Auntie, Uncles, hear me. Hear Reka. Hear her in that quiet bed. Hear her through me. Don't lose this. For there may not be another time. There may not be a better opportunity. This is the time. Now. Don't postpone it. Don't let her pain be in vain. This is the time we come together. And we must mean it. We must respect each other. It starts with two families. These two families. There is no shame in saying sorry to each other. It makes us more mature and humane. Do you know what we were planning to do? We weren't in a relationship as you may think. We were friends, yes. Just simple and innocent friends. Black man and coolie man can be friends. Friends. She wanted to become Miss Guyana. I wanted to start by entering the youth pageant. She said she would only do it if I would be there to give her company. Only with me would she do it, for she trusts me. She was so excited. We couldn't wait.
We referred to it as doing that thing.
We never meant any harm or disrespect. She believed that pageant would give her a good platform to launch her ideas. But she wasn't certain that you, Uncle Surma, and you, Auntie Kunti, would agree. That is why she wanted my support. You were to do it 2 weeks ago by signing her up. But this fence prevented us. She would have told you the right time. No, instead of entering, she may be leaving.
Oh, no.
Do you hear me? Leaving. But she will always be my Miss Guyana, whether here or not. My Guyana, full of hope, full of potential, if given the opportunity to flourish. Let's not hold her back. By fighting, you're holding her back. You're holding us back. My Eureka, my Miss Guyana's heart because of you two and this symbol of division that you put up. Who will save her? Who? Only you could. Only you could save her. Only you could save her. All of you. All of you.
My son.
All of you.
Get up. Get up, son. Get up. Thank you. I heard.
Really? Or is this just another attempt to sugarcoat everything?
I heard, okay? I heard.
Really?
Yes.
Thanks, Uncle. Uncle, you could do this. Dad, you could do this, Mom. Uncle Cabbage. Uncle Fred, Auntie Kunti. You all could do this. We are all Guyanese, simple Guyanese. Let's remove the hatred from our hearts and minds.
Yes, sir.
Let's try to save my Miss Guyana. My Eureka now.
Why we didn't see it like you, eh? Why? Thank you, son. Thank you. We. He's right. He is right. When we gonna start learn, eh? When? We didn't learn anything in my lifetime. We can't just go around blaming the politicians alone. We first got to take the blame. We're not spared from this. We're not. In the end,
is we who fight each other. We curse each other. We spew hatred. For what? Your son is a revelation. Your daughter, an inspiration. Let's unlock our ears and our eyes. Thank you. Thank you, son. I just wish my daughter would have been here to see this moment. I may never hold her again. What have I done? What have I done? What have we done? What? We killed her! We killed her! We killed her! Oh, what have we done?
It's never too late, Uncle. She still has life. I'm sure she will feel better if she knows that there is no more fighting. I'm sure she will get a strength in spirit, even if she knows that we are a family again. She would rest peacefully if she knows that unity has returned. Even if she leaves, she would do so peacefully knowing that we have changed. She knows we cannot exist without each other, despite how we fool ourselves every day. We need each other more than we think. For my country to win, for Rieke to win. Let's do this for you. Do it for us. Do it for our future.
Sorwa again, Sorwa.
You better, because I never call a long name like Rope you got. You got more names than the telephone directory.
Hey, speak for yourself.
Yarobanaba, Sabakishida, Yarobanaba, Sabakishida, Osa chica doya, Osa chica, Osa chica doya, Osa bonua, Osa chica yaro, Osa chica yaro, Osa chica yaro, Deko nakama, Deko nakama yaro, Deko nakama. Osa chica doya, Osa chica. Kai maboro damo yaro, kai maboro damo yaro, kai maboro damo yaro, deko nakama. Osa chica doya, Osa chica. Osa chica doya, osa bonua.
Harmony come in. together. We are multicultural. Let's respect color, creed, and race. Let's embrace each other now and ensure each has a place.